All right, everybody, you're getting a double whammy of videos for today. This is a quick little video on my sleep system from my bug out bag, my primary bug out bag. And I've gone through some of these items in the past when I showed you guys my bug out bag video. If you didn't see it, you can go back to my videos, it's on there. It's probably one of my most watched videos. I should make or name all my videos bug out bag, because it seems that the term bug out bag gets a lot of views. So let's get into it, all right? Now, first of all, my sleep survival system. I don't believe in carrying a lot for this nature. I don't believe in carrying a tent. I don't believe in carrying a heavy sleeping bag. My bug out bag is for if I gotta grab and go and bug out to get me by. Now, I have enough in there where I can survive for a while, and I can prefer to make my shelter, okay, than to have to carry all that extra weight. Now, this may look like a lot, but it doesn't take up much space in the bag. All right, let's put this. First of all, this I keep in there. All right, this is an emergency tent. You can pick these up for about $6. It's basically a little heavier and bigger space blanket or survival blanket, emergency blanket, we'll call it, and some cordage. This is in case I got to throw something together super, super quick and I don't have time to do anything else. And this is, I keep this to the front of my pack so I can just grab it. I don't have to grab anything else. Okay. Of course, you need cordage. Jute twine, I keep them for two things. A, as cordage, and B, for fire tinder. So I have usually keep three small rolls of this because they flatten out in there. So I just took one out for now. Power cord, all right, I keep 50 feet. I don't need more than that to build the shelter. Titan survival cord. FLP, Ring Lace Prepper, sent me this in a giveaway challenge that I won. I'm not going to get into it, but it's got all kinds of cool stuff in there. Fishing line and everything all. Snare wire all interwoven in this line. But it's also good for making shelter if we needed to as well, so I put it in there, it's 100 feet of it. You want to know more about this stuff, check out FLP's video on this. All right, as far as making a shelter, okay, you got your cordage right there. I keep one blue tarp, okay, 5x9. I keep a 7x9 camo tarp, and a 55-gallon drum liner. 5 gallon drum liner, I keep it for multiple purposes. I keep it as if I need to use it as a sleeping bag, believe it or not, you can if you had to, right? I don't know if you really want to, but you could if you needed to. But I keep it mainly for a ground cloth and for water, as a ground cloth and also for water collection if need be. But it makes excellent ground cloth. Also, depending on the situation, okay, I have either this or this to build a shelter with. Now, I can build a tent-type shelter, I can build a teepee-type shelter, I can build a low-lying shelter where I have the tarp real low to the ground for real heavy rain if I have no trees, no branches, no kind of wood to work with, okay? I can just use literally some stakes and this, and I can make myself a shelter to keep me out of the rain. Off the ground, out of the rain. As far as keeping me somewhat warm, moving blanket. I keep a moving blanket, okay? Yes, some of you are gonna say it's not the warmest thing in the world. It's not, okay? It's not made, it's not the warmest thing in the world. I also don't live in the Canadian Rockies or anything like that, you know? I don't need anything any warmer than this and this. I also keep a small space blanket in there if I need be to reflect my own body heat back on, or I could use this. All right, but this is what I keep. This is my sleep system. Very basic. Any of you who know how to survive or are good at it, you guys all know that every one of these items I'm showing you right here will and can keep you alive. Now, if you live in an environment where it's 20, 30 below zero all the time, this is not going to be the best option for you. But for me, this is a great option for my bug out bag. This is what I carry. It's very light. I can pick this all up with one hand, no problem. It takes up this much space. I mean, that's how much space it takes up in my bug out bag. Nothing. Blanket, moving blanket's extremely light, and it's warm enough to keep me warm in conjunction with my other items. So that's my sleep system. It's a little VR, I guess, to my buddy Dash Out was talking about his sleep and shelter system. So, you know, if you guys don't know who Dash Out is, by the way, check him out. Check out his channel. He comments on my pages a lot. You'll see him. Cool guy. Makes a lot of cool fire starting kits. But check out his channel. This is my, like, again, this is it. This is my sleep system, sleep/shelter system. It's all I carry in my main bug out bag. Go back and check out the video if you want to see the rest of the bag. All right, guys. Have a great day. Love you all. Stay safe. Stay strong.